Ladies and gentlemen, it's here. The Fallout trailer finally dropped. And it looks so good. So today I thought we could do an in-depth analysis of not just the trailer, but everything we know about the Fallout show so far. So in the trailer, we get to see the inside of Vault 33. Currently, we know nothing about this vault and its experiment, but I'm sure whatever it is, it's pretty fucked up. We then see our main character, a Vault 33 resident played by Ella Purnell, named Lucy, who appears to either be getting exiled from the vault or she's leaving on her own. Her description provided by Amazon reads, "Lucy is an optimistic vault dweller with an all-American can-do spirit. Her peaceful and idealistic nature is tested when people harm her loved ones. Perhaps the reason she leaves is to save the people of her vault, kind of like in Fallout 1. Either way, it seems like this is her first time leaving the vault based on the tone of the trailer. We can also see a few bodies scattered throughout the scene, indicating that there was some sort of conflict going on inside the vault. Perhaps this vault is similar to Vault 101 where no one was allowed to leave? Only time will tell." Then we get a shot of Venice Beach confirming that the show will take place in the city of Los Angeles, California. This is great news because I feel like the most interesting lore in the Fallout universe comes from the West Coast, which makes me all the more excited to see what they do with this show. What's also exciting is that this show takes place in 2296, which is 15 years after New Vegas and 9 years after Fallout 4. Speaking of New Vegas, it's the last game to take place on the West Coast, and it came out in 2010, so this will be the first time we are getting new West Coast lore since New Vegas came out 13 years ago. The time period of this show means that we might get some new information on what happened after the events of the other Fallout games. Who knows, maybe they'll give us some info on who won the Battle of Hoover Dam, or maybe we get to know who the sole survivor sided with in the Fallout 4 main quest. Or maybe, just maybe, we'll see the return of Fisto. Okay, that might be a little far-fetched, but I can dream, can't I? We then get a shot of a rad roach on a windowsill, which is cool because I wasn't sure how close Amazon was gonna go in sticking with what creatures appear in the show, because as we know, the mutated creatures of the Fallout universe can be pretty wacky. From what we can gather from the next couple shots, it seems that there is not much left of LA, as we can see there's not many buildings behind the Venice boardwalk. In another shot, we can see our protagonist walking along the coast where there is nothing but sand and an abandoned ship. This can be because LA got nuked and there's nothing left, or perhaps it could be because the Pacific dried up and that's why there's this shipwreck in this shot. I don't know, I'm just speculating. We then cut to a shot of a guy who is played by Michael Emerson warning our protagonist about the dangers of the wasteland, to which we then get a shot of a German shepherd fucking up this rad roach who may or may not be dog meat. Either way, he's super cute. We then get our first look at the Brotherhood of Steel, who are seen flying vertebrates out of this base in the middle of the desert, to which we then get our first look at another one of the characters in the show, Maximus, played by Aaron Moden. His description reads as follows, "A young soldier hides his tragic past as he serves in a militaristic faction called the Brotherhood of Steel. He believes in the nobility of the Brotherhood's mission to bring law and order to the wasteland and will do anything to further their goals. Perhaps we are going to get the old Zionist, isolationist versions of the Brotherhood like we did in the Obsidian titles. Again, only time will tell." We then get a really cool shot of a Brotherhood soldier wearing T-60 power armor, which is interesting because the T-60 class of power armor are only used in the Brotherhood of Steel on the East Coast, while the West Coast chapter sticks to the traditional T-51 power armor. However, later in the trailer, there's one piece of evidence that may suggest that this is not a West Coast chapter of the Brotherhood, which I will get to later. We go on to get some more shots of Vault 33, which shows a riot ensuing. In this shot, we see this guy screaming in a fit of rage, perhaps suggesting that either something made him go insane, or perhaps he's just rioting because of something that might be wrong with the leadership in the vault, like in Vault 101. Either way, this scene suggests that not all is well inside Vault 33. However, despite the riot, this vault seems to be thriving, as they have crops lined up in this shot and a pen which may suggest that they have farm animals down there. It seems as though whatever this vault's experiment was, it doesn't seem to be as fucked up as some of the others. We then get a shot of Lucy looking out upon some kind of shantytown, perhaps similar to Diamond City or maybe even Megaton. We then get another shot inside the same town of another character known only as the Ghoul. The Ghoul is played by Walter Goggins, and his description reads as follows. "The Ghoul survives the wasteland as a bounty hunter. He is pragmatic, ruthless, and hides a mysterious past. My guess is that this bounty hunter is hired by Lucy to help her in her mission to save the people of her vault." We then get a shot of this guy's house, to which we then see him walking outside of his home in his underwear. In the former scene, we can see Lucy walking away from a working car of some kind. I honestly was hoping she would be driving a highwayman, but this seems like some regular old-timey car. I don't know, I'm not a car guy. Sorry to all the car guys that are watching this video. But if you guys can figure out the name of this car or something similar, please let me know in the comments. We then cut back to the shantytown mentioned previously, where our ghoul character is engaging in a shootout with some unknown assailants. We then get this sick shot of the ghoul shooting this guy in the face with what looks to be a sawed-off shotgun. We then get a shot of this guy who... What the fuck? Okay, so in this shot, this guy has only one eye. He doesn't look like a ghoul, so perhaps he's the result of some kind of vault experiment. He's also sitting in the overseer's chair, and we know he's not the overseer of Vault 33, because according to Amazon themselves, the Vault 33 overseer is this guy, who we see a little later in the trailer. His name is Overseer Hank, and he's played by Kyle MacLachlan. His description reads, "Hank is the overseer of Vault 33, and Lucy's father. He is eager to change the world for the better." And in this shot, he seems to be either locking Lucy out of a room, maybe to recreate how your father died in Fallout 3, or he's locking her in somewhere and he's doing his best Vault 101 evil tyrant overseer impression. Either way, he looks distressed. Anyways, back to this guy. Because we know he's not the overseer of Vault 33, perhaps Lucy is visiting other vaults in this show. We then get a shot of an automated turret shooting at our beloved German Shepherd friend who may or may not be dog meat, to which we then cut to a shot of Lucy being pushed around by a Mr. Handy in what looks to be some kind of abandoned building. I hope they give the Mr. Handys British accents like in Fallout 3 and 4. We then get a shot of some kind of battle going on between the Brotherhood and an unknown enemy, in which we see this awesome shot of a Brotherhood soldier getting fucking wrecked by a Yaogwai. We then get a cool shot of a creature from the old Fallout titles called a Wadamingo. In Fallout 2, Wadamingos are never specified as being either a mutant or an alien creature, as it's never mentioned if it's mutated from an animal or not. However, I have a feeling we might get some answers about this creature's origins in the show. We then get a shot of this vault dweller with a fork in her eye shooting at what looks to be perhaps some kind of pipe weapon. I cannot tell if she's inside a vault or not because the vegetation behind her as well as these steel walls look similar to this shot inside Vault 33 during the riots. However, the background on the right of this shot looks kind of like a sky, so if I had to guess, I think this is outside of the vault. And then holy shit, the motherfucking Prydwen! This shot is the reason that I think that this chapter of the Brotherhood may not be West Coast, because the only airship we know that is canon is the Prydwen from Fallout 4. However, this may not be true because in Fallout Tactics, the Midwest Brotherhood of Steel was also able to travel by airship. However, they crashed outside of Chicago. This means that it is possible that the West Coast Brotherhood could have built their own airship despite Fallout Tactics not being canon. However, this airship just looks so similar to the Prydwen in Fallout 4 that perhaps it could mean that the East Coast Brotherhood expanded west from the Commonwealth all the way over to LA. Either way, this shot is fucking awesome. Then, in our final two shots, we see what looks to be a father putting his daughter on a horse while explosions go off in the background, to which we then get this epic shot of bombs going off across LA. This may or may not be a pre-war scene where we get to see the nukes being dropped, as LA seems relatively intact and not completely gone like in the shot with Venice Beach. We then get our title card and a release date. Mark your calendars, people, because the Fallout community is going to blow up on April 12th when this show finally releases. Thanks for watching the video. I know that this isn't as high quality as my other videos, but I wanted to make this as quickly as I could right after the trailer dropped. If you're new to the channel, please like, subscribe, and check out my other videos. I have a new one dropping within the week, so stay tuned. Anyways, thank you all for 10K, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.